We're now gonna learn how to build a shelter in the middle of the woods.
Bill Mason and his son at canoeing. They are number one. They knew rivers, they knew lakes. And for dinner, they eat rabbits and snakes. Bill Mason and his son at canoeing. They are number one. They knew rivers, they knew lakes. And for dinner, they eat rabbits and snakes.
One of the first things that you need to know when learning how to canoe is how to portage. Portaging is how you get your canoe to the beach and into the water. So the key to a proper portage, as you can see in the video, is to let one person in the front lift up the middle of the canoe and place the weight of it right on their neck. The other person from behind holds it with one or two fingers and watches the action as the other person carries. Once the portage is completed, you slowly take the canoe down with using the weight of the front person and give the thumbs up. The direction of the wind is an important part of paddling, as you need to know what type of resistance you'll be fighting. Paul and I in this video demonstrate how to accurately find out which way the wind is blowing. First of all, use your paddle and wave it around in the air and find out where there is the most resistance. At a given point in time, throw your paddle. Then retrieve it. You will know what way the wind is blowing by where the paddle lands. As you can see, when I throw my paddle, the wind obviously had died down. Retrieve your paddle, head back to the boat, and let's get canoeing. Alright, son, tell us how to properly board a canoe.
When boarding a canoe, make sure the canoe is parallel to the water so the waves splash against the hull. And then stand in the canoe and push off.
That's right, son. And once you're in the water, make sure you stay standing until you're well clear of shore. That gives you more balance, and we did it a little wrong in this video. You want to keep staying parallel to the waves.
Because if not, you could fall just like this.
That's right, son.
Here, a live snail.
It's a bear, Dad.
It's a rare specimen, and you can only find them in the boats of canoes.
In the boats, that's where they live.
That's the only place you'll ever find them.
They die.
You can see, we're taking on a bit of water, so it's like its natural environment.
That's good,
if you
Dad.
Pour some on it, it'll like you more.
How old is it, Bill Mason, Dad?
Well, you can tell by its stripes that it's 6 years old, and now it's starting to move.
It's alive, Bill Mason, Dad.
Yes, it is. And the best thing about these snails is that they're good to eat, so if you fry them off...
That's sure a snail. Hold Bill Mason, Dad.
Fry it off.
Now kiss me, Bill Mason, okay. Dad. So I can...
Kiss me on the cheek. Kiss me.
I tasted it, too.
He tasted it, too.
One of the most efficient strokes to keep you moving in a straight line when there is a wind is called the X stroke. What you do is you have the bow and the stern paddler lift their paddles in the air and wave it in an X formation. This causes wind turbulence, which as you can see keeps us moving in a perfectly straight line as we move beside the dock. This is a very efficient stroke and, well, we touched the dock once, but only once. We're still getting the hang of it. That is the X stroke, ladies and gentlemen, and keep in mind it only works when there is a wind. The next stroke we're going to learn is called the spear stroke, and it is crucial for paddling. Both paddlers stab at the water. How do they stab, son?
Just like we're stabbing the dog again!
Exactly, son. It is a very beautiful and calming stroke, and it turns the canoe gently to the right. The most beautiful part of canoeing is not the canoeing itself, it's enjoying nature with the people you love.
Bill Mason and his son at canoeing, they are number one. They knew rivers, they knew lakes, and for dinner they eat rabbits and snakes. Bill Mason and his son at canoeing, they are number one. They knew rivers, they knew lakes, and for dinner they eat.